Okay. So, the story we talked about, a gift of trees, do you remember what the story's about?
Which one?
What is it about?
It's about the cherry trees.
The cherry blossom trees? And where do the cherry blossom trees come from?
From Japan.
From Japan? And who, where do they want to put these cherry blossom trees?
In Washington, D.C.
Oh, you are so awesome. Yeah, in Washington, D.C. Do you remember the people who thought that it would be a good idea to have the trees? Do you remember the names of the people who thought they wanted the cherry blossom trees in Washington, D.C.? Okay. I'll give you a hint. She was one of the first ladies. Her name was Mrs. Taft, Helen Taft. She was one of them. And then the other lady was Miss Skidmore. Okay. So we read the passage, and then we started going over the questions. What question? You were on question 11? Were you on question 11? Turn the page. To the questions. Okay. So you guys were working on the questions. So I'll go ahead and read. How is Yukio Ozaki different from Mrs. Taft? Now remember, when you're reading the questions, you can refer back to your passage. Make sure you underline the evidence and put the question mark next to it. So that way, when I ask you for the answer, you can give me the evidence. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, go ahead. You can go ahead and answer. You need help, Cecil? Okay. So for number 11, it says, how is Yukio Ozaki different from Mrs. Taft? And it says, A, he lives in the capital of Japan. B, he is a friend of Eliza Skidmore. C, he thinks cherry trees are lovely. Or D, he has spent time in Washington, D.C. How is Yukio Ozaki different from Mrs. Taft? Do you remember who Yukio Ozaki is?
Mm-hmm.
Who is Yukio?
He was the president of Japan.
Who's the mayor of Japan. Okay. So they're wanting to know how he is different from the first lady, Mrs. Taft. Okay. Do you have any questions? So if you remember from the story, Cecil, Mr. Ozaki lived in Japan. And he was he friends with Mrs. Skidmore?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Was he friends with Mrs. Taft?
Yes, ma'am.
So what I would do is eliminate. So go back to your question. Question 11. And it says, the first one says, he lives in the capital of Japan. They're wanting to know, how is he different from Mrs. Taft? Okay, you don't have to erase. I'm just going to put it right here. He lives in the capital of Japan. He is a friend of Eliza Skidmore. Is Ms. Skidmore friends with Mrs. Taft? So we should eliminate that, cross it out, because that's the same, right? They have the same friendship with Mrs. Taft. What about C? He thinks cherry trees are lovely. What does Ms. Taft think?
She thinks they're lovely too.
Okay, so is that different, or is it the same? Okay, so I would eliminate that as well. And And then D, he has spent time in Washington, D.C. Now, when does he go to Washington, D.C.? Do you remember in the story? I believe it's page 10 on the back. If you need me to read it to you, let me know, okay? Okay, so what I would do is on the very bottom, it says in 1950, when he was 92 years old, Yukio Ozaki visited Washington, D.C. How pleased he was to see the trees he had sent 38 years before. Thanks to his gift and Mrs. Tapp's interest in the trees, people in America and in Japan can enjoy the beauty of the cherry blossom. So, Mrs. Tapp lived in Washington, D.C. Did he spend time in Washington, D.C.?
Yes.
But not until he was 92 years old. Did Mrs. Tapp, hold on. Did Mrs. Tapp live in the capital of Japan?
No.
So is that alike or different? Take your time and be so quick to answer. Because when you take the FSA, take your time. Okay. You'll be given that time too.
So.
Alright, what question are you on about?
It's 14.
14? So what happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? F, crowds of people picked cherries from them. Did cherry blossoms grow cherries? Do you remember if the cherry blossom trees grew cherries? If you refer back to this picture, does it have cherries on it? It does. So let's read here. The pink puffs on every tree branch did look like popcorn, but they were really cherry blossoms in full bloom. The tree was a flowering tree. The Japanese call it sakura, which means cherry, but the tree does not bear large, delicious cherries. Does it have cherries? No. Okay. So, what I would do is eliminate. Okay, that means get rid of the answer because in this answer, it says crowds of people pick cherries from them. There are no cherries on the tree. So what would you do? Cross it out. Yeah, X it out. All right, so that's not an answer. So the question again is what happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? G, they became famous for their beautiful blossoms. H, Mrs. Tapp sent them back to Japan many years later. Or I, they were cut down during the first cherry blossom festival. Okay, you want to go back to your passage? You ready? Let me see, can I see question 13? Just look at this one again, okay? Your question is, why did Mayor Ozaki send Mrs. Tapp a second gift of the cherry trees? A, is the first gift was full of harmful insects. first gift died soon after it was planted? Or C, Americans loved the first gift so much that they wanted more? Or D, gardeners cut down the first gift to build the Lincoln Memorial? Okay, so let's go back to your passage. Did you find the answer? So the mayor was, he was very happy that Mrs. Taft was interested in the beautiful trees. And let's see. Okay. Look. Mrs. Taft, let's see, Mrs. Skidmore suggested to Mrs. Taft that a road lined with Japanese flowering trees would look lovely in Washington, D.C. Mrs. Taft liked the idea. So in 1909, she had some cherry trees planted near the place where the Lincoln Memorial now stands. But most of the trees died. When a Japanese visitor heard this, he contacted Yukio Ozaki, who was the mayor of Tokyo, Japan's capital. Ozaki was so pleased with Mrs. Taft's interest in the country, he sent her a gift of 2,000 cherry trees. The trees were lovely, but full of insects, and they all had to be destroyed. So let's go back to your question. And it's asking, so she had already planted trees, and now they're asking about the second group of trees. Let's see. Oh, here it is. I'm sorry, I didn't move on. It says, then Mayor Ozaki sent a new shipment of 3,000 healthy trees. In March 1912, Mrs. Taft planted the first of Washington's cherry trees. A Japanese visitor planted the second one. Gardeners later planted the rest. Okay. It says this time the trees lived and they blossomed. People loved them. By 1927, the cherry trees were so popular that crowds of people gathered to see them. In 1934, the city held America's first official cherry blossom festival. Okay, back to your question. Okay, it says, you did? Okay, we'll go for it. What happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? Crowds of people pick cherry trees, cherries from them, so you eliminated that one because it's not. Oh, sorry, you're not 13. Why did Mayor Ozaki send Mrs. Taft a second gift of cherry trees? The first gift was full of harmful insects. Well, that was the first gift. See, because it says the first gift. They're asking about the second gift. Okay? The first gift died soon after it was planted. So what are we talking about? The second gift. Eliminate. So, C, Americans loved the first gift so much they wanted more. And it's D, gardeners cut down the first gift to build the Lincoln Memorial. Okay, why did Mayor Ozaki send Mrs. Taft a second gift? So that's your answer. Because he found out the first trees had insects. Awesome. So we turn the page to 14. It says, what happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? F, crowds of people picked cherries from them. G, they became famous for their beautiful blossoms. H, Mrs. Taft sent them back to Japan many years later. Or I, they were cut down during the first cherry blossom festival. Okay, let me see what you're doing. Okay, so go back to your passage. Which question are you on? 14.
Okay.
What happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? So you eliminated, let's do this. I'm gonna take this off, and then what I'll do is staple it back so it's easier for you, okay? All right. You eliminated it, awesome. Okay, G, they became famous for their beautiful blossoms. Well, did people come all over to see the trees? Do you remember? Let's see, let's go back to the passage, and it says, in spring, the blossoms can appear all over the country. That's why Japan is often called the land of the cherry blossom. Okay, and it says, each year for nearly 2 weeks, the sakura tree brings fun and festival to Japan. All talk is about the beauty of the year's cherry blossoms. So, they became famous for their blossoms. What happened to the second group of trees sent by Mayor Ozaki? Mrs. Taft sent them back to Japan many years later, or they were cut down during the first cherry blossom festival. What do you think? Do you think people come from all over to see the trees? You have to read, okay?
Okay.
I would start here.
Okay.
So, what's your answer? Yes. Because the cherry blossom trees, you can only see them within 2 weeks when they blossom. And you can see them afterward, but then the flowers fall off of them. Okay, so let's move on to the next question. Which word describes both Eliza Skidmore and Yukio Ozaki? Now remember, Eliza Skidmore is a lady who writes, she's an American named Eliza Skidmore, okay? She was a friend of the 27th President of the United States, William Taft, and his wife, First Lady Helen Taft. Miss Skidmore had visited Japan and had written books about it. She suggested to Mrs. Taft that a road lined with Japanese flowering cherry trees would look lovely in Washington, D.C. All right. Which word describes both Eliza Skidmore and Yukio Ozaki? A, careless. B, curious. C, forgiving. D, thoughtful.
Forgiving
means that if someone does something that they don't like, let's say you do something I don't like, but you tell me you're sorry, then I say, it's okay, I forgive you. That means I forget about it. It's not a big deal. Okay? Do you understand that? Yes? You like my necklace? Yeah. Which one? Forgiving? Well, let's see. Did Miss Skidmore and Mr. Mayor Yukio Ozaki do something to make someone upset in the passage? No. So are you going to eliminate? Okay, good. Now, were they careless? Do you know what careless means? It means they weren't paying attention and they made mistakes. Curious? Do you know what curious is? When you want to know about something. Did Miss Skidmore and Yukio Ozaki want to know about something? What are you pointing to? Well, let me see. If you're thinking it's thoughtful, I would say it's thoughtful because they're thoughtful because Mrs. Skidmore thought that the cherry trees would look lovely in Washington, D.C. It was for the people of the city. And Yukio Ozaki was thoughtful because he liked